Hi, welcome to all. Myself, Thimmegowda MB, working as a lecturer in Mechanical Engineering Department, Government Polytechnic, Thiruvaikere. Today, in this session, I am going to take up the design of fasteners. In this session, we are going to solve the problems on design of bolts. And also at the end, you will have multiple choice questions. In the previous sessions, we have already designed bolts for different loading conditions and designed bolts as studs for cylinder covers, and also we have designed cover plate for cylinders. So in this session, we will design the bolts subjected to initial tightening load as well as external load. That is clearly understood by solving these problems. So this, I am going to take the problem. The cylinder head of a steam engine is subjected to a steam pressure of 0.7 Newton per mm square. It is held in position by means of 12 bolts. A soft copper gasket is used to make the joint leak proof. The effective diameter of the cylinder is 300 mm. Find the size of the bolts so that the stress in the bolts is not to exceed 100 MPa. First, we have to record all the given data and study the problem carefully and concentrate what we have to find to get the solution. Here, the cylinder diameter is given as 300 mm, that is capital letter D is equal to 300 mm. And the pressure inside the cylinder is 0.7 Newton per mm square. And number of bolts used is 12. That means in order to fix the cylinder cover in its place. A soft copper gasket is used to make the joint leak proof. In between the cylinder and the cylinder cover, here we have used a soft copper gasket in order to make the joint leak proof. So that is also to be considered here for calculating the resultant load. But in the previous problems, we have not considered the initial tightening load and the value of K. Here, we have to calculate the value of K also for calculating the load acts on each bolt. Here, we are going to calculate what is the upward force acting on the cylinder. That is, as usual procedure, F is equal to P into A. That is pressure into area, where area is corresponding to area cylinder. That is equal to F is equal to P into pi by 4 capital letter D square. D is the diameter of the cylinder. That is equal to 0.7 into pi by 4 into 300 square. On calculating this, you will get 49.48 into 10⁻³ Newton. This is the force acts on the cylinder cover that will be transferred to all the 12 bolts. Therefore, load acts on each bolt is given by FA is equal to total load divided by number of bolts, that is F by N, that is equal to 49.48 into 10⁻³ divided by 12. That is equal to 4.123 into 10⁻³ Newton, that is 4.123 kilonewton. This is the load acts on each bolt because of internal pressure. That's why it is considered as external load. External load acts on each board is 4.123 kilonewton. Next, we have to find the initial load, initial tightening load. Initial tightening load is calculated by using the formula F is equal to 2805D. That is available in design data and book in page number 127. The equation number is here in the data and book. You will get that equation. In equation number 9.1C, in page number 127, you will get that equation. That is the equation for calculating the initial tightening load in a bolt. That is Fi is equal to 2805D. And next, we are going to calculate. Now you have calculated initial load and as well as external load on each bolt. Therefore, the total resultant load acts on each bolt is given by F is equal to KFA plus Fi. That is by considering the gaskets. K is nothing but relative elastic heating of the gasket material. There are different values of K for different type of joints. That is available in design data handbook in table 9.1, page number 136. In the problem, we have used soft copper gasket. For soft copper gasket, the value of K is 0.5. If you open the design data handbook in page number 136, you will get the type of joints. In type of joints, you will get the value of K. Here we have used soft copper gaskets. For soft copper gasket, the value of K is 0.5. Suppose in this problem you have used asbestos, then the value of K is 0.6. Now we have to calculate the resultant load acts on each bolt. Resultant load is nothing but considering initial load as well as external load and also the value of K. Substitute the value of Fe and Fi in resultant load equation. That is equal to F is equal to 0.5 into 4.123 into 10 raised to 3 plus 2805D. We don't know the value of T. That's why we have written as it is. So this becomes equation number 1. F is equal to, that means resultant load acts on each bolt is given by 2061.66 plus 2805D. Next, we are going to equate this resultant load acts on each bolt to the load on each bolt. That means load carried by each bolt. Load carried by each bolt is given by F is equal to stress into area. Here where A corresponding to core diameter, pi by 4 dc square into sigma b. There we have dc value. Okay, in order to convert that dc into d value, there is a one relationship between core diameter and measure diameter. That is dc is equal to 0.84T. Okay, we substitute this DC value in that total load on bolt is given by load on bolt is given by stress into area, stress into pi by 4 DC square, 100 into pi by 4. DC is taken as 0.84 times of D. That is the relationship between core diameter and the measure diameter. So, because in LHS we have unknown parameter D, so that's why we have converted core diameter into measure diameter by using the relation 0.84 times of D. On solving this, you will get 55.41 D square, and consider this as equation number 2. Now I'm going to equate these equations 1 and 2. Because resultant load acts on each bolt is equal to load resisted by each bolt or load on bolt. That is equal to 55.41 D square is equal to 2061.66 plus 2805d. On simplifying this equation, that means divided by 55.41 and move this 2805d to LHS side, you will get d square minus 2805d divided by 55.41 is minus 50.62d, and minus 2061.6 divided by 55.41 gives minus 37.2 is equated to 0. This is in the form of quadratic equation. So this quadratic equation is solved by finding the roots of quadratic equation. We know that finding the roots of quadratic equation, we know that roots of quadratic equation is given by x is equal to minus b plus or minus b square minus 4ac divided by 4a. Here substitute the coefficients of a, b and value of c. Here the coefficient of b is minus 50.62 and coefficient of a is 1 and coefficient of c is minus 37.2. On solving this you will get 51.34 mm. This is the calculated one. So in design of bolt and nuts we are going to choose the standard values. So from design data handbook in table 9.8 page number 143, the standard diameter available is 52 mm. It is a major diameter or nominal diameter of the bolt. Even this equation is solved by directly by using your calculator. There you will get equations. There you have to select the second order equation and substitute the coefficient of d square d and this constant term. You will directly get the values of d. Even you don't need this quadratic equation. Directly you can solve it by using calculator. This is how we are going to calculate the diameter of the bolts considering initial load as well as external load. In the problem, he has mentioned gaskets. You should be careful while solving the problem. If he has given the gasket, you have to use initial tightening load as well as external load and the value of K and find the resultant load. That resultant load is equated to the load on bolt. Then you will get the diameter of the bolt. Okay. Next, I am moving to simple problem. Two machine parts are fastened together tightly by means of a 24 mm tap bolt. If the load tending to separate these parts is neglected, find the stress that is set up in the bolt by the initial tightening. Here, two machine parts are connected together by means of tap bolt. The size of the tap bolt is 24 mm and the load tending to separate these parts is neglected. That means external load is zero. That means external load is negligible. That means neglected. Find the stress that is set up in the bolt by initial tightening. That means with the help of spanners we will tighten these tap bolts. Okay. While tightening, what is the stress induced in the bolts? That is calculated by using simple stress equation. Stress is equal to force by area. In that force, we are going to consider the initial tightening load. That initial tightening load is calculated by using the empirical relation, that is 2805d. Before calculating the initial load for the given diameter 24 mm, we will select the core diameter because you have to calculate the core area. For 24 mm, the core diameter is available in design data handbook in table 9.8 page number 142. Core diameter is 20.32 mm. Now we are going to calculate the initial tightening load, that is 2805d, that is available in data handbook equation number 9.1c page number 127. On calculating this, you will get 67.32 into 10 raised to 3 newton. This is the initial load. This is used for calculating the stresses developed in the tap bolt. That is, stress is equal to force by area. Stress is equal to F by cross sectional area. Fi by pi by 4 dc square. we know the value of Fi, we know the value of DC, so that we can easily calculate the stress that is set up in the tab board. F is equal to stress into pi by 4 D square. Here you have to take Fi. Yeah, that I symbol is missed here. 67.32 into 10 raised to 3, sigma b is equal to pi by 4 into 20.32 square. And simplification, you will get 207.59 newton per mm square. That is equal to 207.59 mega pascal. That means, while tightening the tap bolt with the help of spanners, we will get, that means the stress induced in the bolt is 207.59 mega pascal. This is because of initial tightening load, not the external load. Next, I want to another problem. Two components are connected by a bolt. By the initial pressure load on the bolt is 4 kN. The external load acting on the bolt is 7.5 kN. The bolt with core thread is made up of plain carbon steel having yield strength of 375 newton per mm square. Taking factor of safety as 3, design the size of the bolt. Take k is equal to 0.5. First, collect the given data. Here, the initial pressure load, that is Fi is equal to 4 kN. Directly, he has given the value. And another one, external load. External load is also given, that is Fa. But in the previous problem, you have calculated initial load as well as external load. Here is directly given those values. And the bolt with core thread is made up of plain carbon steel having yield strength 375 newton per mm square. In this problem, he has given the yield strength, not the working or safe or permissible stress. If he has given the yield strength, we have to calculate the working or design stress or allowable stress by considering factor of safety. Therefore, allowable stress is equal to yield stress divided by factor of safety. Design the size of the bolt, take k is equal to 0.5. Size of the bolt, that means you have to calculate the value of DC and D, and k is given 0.5. Firstly, I am going to calculate the allowable stress because that is used in design process. Sigma y divided by factor of safety, 375 divided by 3, you will get 125 newton per millimeter square. This is the allowable stress. Next, we are going to calculate the resultant load on each bolt. F is equal to KFA plus Fi. Substitute the given values, 0.5 into 7.5 into 10 raised to 3 plus 4 into 10 raised to 3, you will get 7.75 into 10 raised to 3 newton. That is equal to 7.75 kilo newton. That is the load acts on each bolt. That is because this is the resultant load. Okay. Next, that resultant load carried by the bolts. That is resultant load acts on each bolt is equal to load on each bolt. F is equal to stress into area, stress into pi by 4 DC square. The resultant load is 7.75 into 10 raised to 3 is equal to stresses, allowable stress is 125, that is calculated by considering yield stress and factor of safety into pi by 4 DC square. On calculating this, that means on simplification, you will get the value of DC as 8.88 mm. This is the calculated one. For this calculated value, we are going to select the standard core diameter from design data and book. That is in table 9.8, page number 141. You will get the standard values. Closer to value of 88 is 9.08 mm. That is core diameter. And corresponding to this core diameter, the major diameter is 10 mm. Next, this is the last problem, and this problem is similar to the problem that is explained in the previous session. An I bolt is to be used for lifting a rod of 60 kN. Find the nominal diameter of the bolt. If the tensile stress is not to exceed 100 MPa, assume coarse threads. F is given. You have to calculate the diameters and stress is given, that is 100 MPa, and that is equal to 100 Newton per mm square. We know that the force acting on the boat is given by F is equal to stress into area, that is equal to stress into pi by 4 dc square. Substitute the given values, and on simplification you will get core diameter as 27.63. Yeah, this is also a calculated one, and select the standard values from design data handbook. That is, DC is equal to 28.16 mm and D is equal to 30 mm. These are all the problems in design of fasteners, in design of bolts. Majorly, we have calculated the size of the bolts by considering external load, and we have considered the external load for the given size of the bolts, and we have calculated the size of the bolts for cylinder covers, and we have checked the leak proof joint, and next we have calculated the size of the bolts by considering initial load as well as external load. Okay, in the problem is mentioned any gasket material, you have to calculate the initial load as well as external load, and then calculate the resultant load, and then equate it to the load on bolt. You will get the diameters. Please remember these points while designing a bolts in design of fasteners. That means while solving the problems, you should remember all these points. Next, I move on to the last session, that is I am going to conclude this in design of fasteners, in design of bolts. We have learned the design of bolts for initial load as well as external load. Okay. In end examination, you will get the problems for 10 marks, or even in some cases you will get it for 15 marks. Based, suppose if the theory portion is given for 5 marks, you will get the problem for 15 marks. If the theory portion is given for 10 marks, you will get the problems for 10 marks. Okay, all type of problems are explained in my sessions. Okay, please go through this. You will get an idea to design the bolts. Now I am move on to the multiple choice questions. The resultant axial load acts on each bolt is given by F is equal to Fi plus K into Fa, F is equal to Fa plus K into Fi, F is equal to Fi plus K into Fa, none of the above. Okay, this is the another multiple choice question. The initial tension in a bolt used for making not fluid tight joint is calculated by using the relation 1403D, 2805D, 1403DC, 2805D. Usually, for not making the fluid tight joint, it is half of the empirical relation that is used for fluid-tight joint. Next, the third MCQ question is, the initial tension in a bolt for leak-proof joint based on experiments may be found by the relation 2805D, 2805DC, 1420DC, 1420D. Next one, the value of K for soft cap, soft copper gasket for fluid-tight joint is 0.5101.5. Next one, the bolts less than dash mm diameter is never be used for fluid tight joints. 16 mm, 18 mm, 20 mm, 24 mm. Next, the factor of safety is the ratio of yield stress to working stress, ultimate stress to working stress, both A and B, none of the above. Okay. Next one, resisting force offered by n number of bolts is calculated by using the relation F is equal to pi by 4 dc square into n, F is equal to pi by 4 dc square, F is equal to pi by 4 d square into n, all the above. Next, what is the value of stress if the load is 10 kN and the core area is 100 mm square? Here we have to calculate the value of stress by using simple stress equation. So 100 newton per mm square, 100 newton per meter square, 1 newton per millimeter square, 10,000 newton per millimeter square. This is a simple one, you can easily calculate using calculator. Next, weakest cross section of the bolt is cross section at root diameter, cross section at major diameter, cross section at pitch diameter, none of the above. Next, the value of K for soft packing with studs. 0.5, 1, 0, 1.5. Which one is used for soft packing with studs? Okay, these are all the answers to above multiple choice questions. For 1 it is A, for 2 it is A, for 3 it is A, for 4 it is A, 5 it is A, 6 it is C, 7 it is A, 8 it is A, 9 it is A, and 10 it is B. Please compare your answers with these answers so that you can easily understand the concepts. Okay. Thank you.